Do you need to create a guest registration form? Well, let me show you how with JotForm. Hey JotFormers, welcome back. I'm Kimberly, and like I mentioned, if you're wanting to create an online registration form, JotForm can definitely help you do that. And there's a lot of benefits to doing it this way over paper. Some things include streamlining the process, having the guest list in one place, and ensuring a seamless guest experience. Having your guest registration form online is going to save you time, it's going to avoid mistakes, and it's going to help you organize your data in a very easy way. One of my favorite reasons to utilize online forms is that it updates in real time. So let me show you how to do this. As you can see, I'm currently in the desktop version of my workspace. So I'm gonna go to the top left-hand corner. We're gonna choose to create. I'm gonna choose a form. And from here, we have a lot of different options. We can either start from scratch. So if you know exactly how you want this form to look, you can utilize that. We have over 10,000 pre-made templates. We can create a form utilizing AI. If we have a PDF form, if you already have that paper version, you can input that and it'll start mapping fields for you. We have e-sign forms. And then of course, if you have an existing form, you can import that. But for this example, I'm gonna go ahead and utilize one of our templates. Now, if you know exactly what you're looking for, you can always utilize the search option right up here at the top. But over on the left-hand side, we can see we have lots of different types of forms, even different industries and professions. But I want to do a form that is for a wedding. And I'm looking for one that's more for attendance. And I think I'm going to utilize this right here. Will you attend our wedding? So let's go ahead and utilize this template. Now, whenever I'm working with a template, I always want to do a quick scroll just to see what I'm working with. Up here at the top, we can see we have a heading section, will you attend our wedding, with a brief description underneath. We have some form fields. We see this one right here. We have this red asterisk, which means that it is going to be required. We have name, email, number of adults, number of children, and a message to the bride and the groom. Okay, so these are great. We're gonna add some more in just a minute, but let's talk about making this look and feel more like our wedding vibe. So in the top right-hand corner, I'm gonna click that paint roller. And here is where we can change the overall vibe of our form. So I am going to go ahead right here. The page color is going to be this background, and then the form color is going to be what your questions are sitting on. So we can choose a file. We can go upload, and I'm going to choose a photo to upload. And let's say this is where we're planning on getting married. So we have that view in the back. If you want, we can also change the overall font. Let's come back over here to styles. We can change the font to something else if we would like. I'm actually okay with enter. We can make the font size bigger. But one thing we definitely want to do is we want to make sure that all of these are required because we want their information. Perfect. I want to make sure there's a message as well. So let's go ahead and close out of this. So we know that we have whether they can attend, we have how many people are coming, but we also want to know, are they going to come to the reception afterwards? So we can do add an element, and we can come down here. We can do a drop down right here. So will you be attending the reception? We'll say yes, no, perfect. And again, we also want to make sure that that is required. And we also want to give them a chance to give their food preference. Perfect. And with this, we can even play with conditional logic. So for example, if someone says they're not going to be attending the reception, we don't want them to give us a food preference. One thing I want to do while we are here is I actually want to hide this field because we're going to be doing some conditional logic. So for example, if someone says they aren't coming to the reception, they don't need to see that food preference question. So in the top middle, I'm gonna choose settings. Then on the left, conditions, we're gonna show hide field. Let's say if will you be attending the reception is equal to yes, because that question is currently hidden, we want to show the food preference. We'll do save. Let's do a quick preview. And if we scroll down, we can see here the food question is no longer there. So let's choose no, question is not there. So if we choose yes, then the food preference populates. All right, so let's talk about sharing this form. In the very, very top, let's go ahead and get out a preview form. We'll choose publish, and there's a lot of different ways that you can do this. As of right now, it's a public form. So anytime you copy this link and share this link out, anyone is going to be able to access this form. Now, if you want, you can change it from a public form to a private form. And this way, only the people that you give access to will be able to access it. I'll leave it on public form just for now. We get invite by email, so if you want, you can import emails, or you can list them one by one here. We can also share the form via social media, and you can even print out a QR code to include on any printouts that you have going out. So let's go ahead and give this a test. I'm gonna go back over to the top right. Let's do preview form, and I'm gonna do a quick fill form. All right, we have can attend. We have John Smith. He is going to be attending the reception. Chose beef. Two adults, one child. Congratulations. Can't wait to see you walk down the aisle. So let's go ahead and submit. All right, let's jump out of preview form. Top left-hand corner, we're currently in the form builder. Let's jump over to our tables. This is where you're gonna view all of your incoming data. So here we can see John Smith. We can see all of his information, but this isn't all you can do with tables. There's lots of different filtering options as well. So let's say we need to know, we want everyone who can attend. We'll apply that filter. Perfect. And we can create a new tab. So we can say yes to attending. Okay, so every time someone fills out a form and they say yes, I can attend, they're gonna fall into the overall wedding attendance, but they're gonna fall also into the yes to attending. So what we can also do is X out of this filter. Let's do another filter, and let's say we want to know everyone who has chosen, we'll just stick with beef, apply filter. Perfect, we'll create a new tab. We'll call this one beef. So that way we have an easy idea of how many people chose specific things. Now, another thing you can do in the overall one and additional ones as well, but you can choose these three dots and you can summarize with a chart so you can see easily percentages. You can have this be a bar chart, a pie chart, a donut chart. We can change that right up here. Perfect. And it really is as simple as that. Again, if you want to save time and avoid mistakes and have all your data updating instantaneously within JotForm, give JotForm Forms a try for your next event. If you like this video, let us know down below in the comments. And don't forget to subscribe and turn on the bell so you get notification every time we put out a new video. I'll see you next time.